Dear learners, welcome to the MSBT online learning platform, MSBT Lead Learning at Your Doorsteps. I am Mrs. Sonali Sharigar, lecturer in Electronics and Telecommunication Engineering Department at Agnel Polytechnic, Navi Mumbai. Unit 5 is applications of 8051 microcontroller, and the unit outcome is control the given parameter using 8051 microcontroller. The learning objective of this presentation is develop program for DAC to generate triangular waveform. At the end of this presentation, you will be able to develop an assembly language program for DAC to generate triangular wave. The content of this presentation are triangular wave generation concept and program for generation of triangular wave. This is concept map. As you can see, microcontroller 8051 sends digital data corresponding to triangular wave to 8-bit DAC. 8-bit DAC converts this digital data into analog form and thereby generates a triangular waveform. The concept of triangular wave generation is very simple. To generate a triangular wave, DAC should be supplied with a range of digital input values starting from 0, next incrementing by 1, and so on, one after the another. The incremented value should be given to DAC till a maximum value is reached. Once a maximum value is reached, again the value should be decremented by 1, and one after the another decremented value should be given to DAC till a minimum 0 value is reached. The digital input values and the corresponding analog output voltage is tabulated for your reference. As we are using 8-bit DAC, the maximum input to a DAC we can give is FFH. As you can see in the table, if the input is 00H, that means all 8 bits of DAC are 0, the analog output voltage is 0 volt. When the input is 20H, hexadecimal 20H or decimal 32H, the output voltage is 0.627 volts. The output voltage corresponding to a particular input value depends upon the step size of the DAC. Learners, you must have learned step size of DAC in Unit 4. As you can see in the table, when we give the maximum digital input FFH to DAC, the analog output voltage we get is 5 volts. Diagram shows DAC 0808 interfaced with microcontroller. As you can see, 8 digital inputs of DAC A1 to A8 are connected to 8 port pins of port 1. To generate a triangular wave, port 1 of 8051 should be programmed to output digital values from 00H to FFH one after the another, so that the analog output voltage of DAC varies linearly from 0 volt to 5 volt. Once the maximum output is reached, again port 1 should output the digital values in decrementing order till 00H, so that the analog output voltage of the DAC will now decrease linearly from 5 volt to 0 volt. This cycle should be repeated continuously to generate a continuous triangular waveform. Steps to generate triangular wave are, first, send the digital value 00H to DAC so that the output of DAC is 5 volts. Next, increment this value by 1. Now, the value sent to DAC becomes 01H. Compare this value 01H with the highest value FFH and send it to DAC. So, keep on incrementing the value to be sent to DAC by 1 and keep on sending it to DAC till it reaches FFH. Then, after the maximum value FFH is sent to DAC, now decrement the value by 1, so it becomes FEH. Compare this decremented value with the lowest value 00H and send it to DAC. Keep on decrementing the value and sending it to DAC till the value reaches 00H, and repeat this process continuously. Let us understand the program to generate triangular wave. The first instruction, move A, hash 00H, loads the first value 00H in accumulator. The next instruction, move A, sends this value in accumulator to port 1 where DAC is connected. As a result, 0 volt is generated. Next instruction, INCA, increments the value in A by 1. So now the value in A becomes 01H. Instruction CJNE, A, hash 0FFH, up. Compares the value in A with the maximum value 0FFH. As the value in A is not equal to 0FFH, the program control jumps to up, where again the value in A, which is now 01H, is sent to port 1.
again INCA instruction increments the value by 1, and this process is repeated continuously till the value in A becomes equal to 0FFH. When the value in A becomes equal to 0FFH, the instruction CJNE A, hash 0FFH transfers the program control to next line, which is go move P1, A. So the value in A, which is 0FFH, is sent to port 1. As a result, DAC generates maximum output voltage, let's say plus 5 volts. Next, instruction DECA decrements the value in A by 1, which becomes FEH. CJNE A, hash 00H, go compares the value in A with the minimum value 00H. As they are not equal, the program control is shifted to label go, where the value in A is sent to port 1 and DAC generates the next voltage level. Again, DECA is executed, value in A is compared with 00H, and the program control is transferred to go. These steps are repeated till value in A becomes equal to 00H. Once the value in A becomes equal to 00H, the program control is shifted to next line, which is S jump repeat. As a result, the whole program is repeated again continuously, thereby giving us a continuous triangular waveform.
Now let us simulate the program in Keel. As you can see, this is a program for triangular wave generation. Let's build the target. We get zero errors, zero warnings. Also, X file is created. Let's debug the program now. As you can see in the debug window, you can see port 1 window, as well as you can see logic analyzer window. So in the logic analyzer window, you can get the waveform output. Let us run the program. As you can see, when the program is run, port 1 is outputting values from 00H to FFH and from FFH to 00H gradually, one after the another, which can be seen as triangular wave in the logic analyzer window. As you can see, the positive slope of the triangular wave is because of the port 1 values from 00H to FFH, and the falling slope is due to the port 1 values decrementing from FFH to 00H. Thus, we can see the program logic is working properly in Keel. Now, let us also check the circuit simulation, wherein we will interface a DAC with microcontroller 805, and here you can see DAC 0808 is interfaced with microcontroller, and the analog output of DAC is connected to CRO. The hex file which we have just now generated has been burned in the IC, and when I simulate the circuit simulation software, we can see that a triangular wave is generated. Thus, you can generate a triangular wave by appropriately programming microcontroller to output values so that a triangular wave is generated. Dear learners, attempt MCQ set 1. Thank you.